of Scholl College and community presence has begun a new generation of podiatric excellence.
Hi, my name is Carl. I'm a second-year podiatry student. For 90 years, Scholl was located in downtown Chicago. Recently, we transitioned to the northern suburbs of Chicago as part of Rosalind Franklin University. However, even with the new campus and expanded resources, the college has retained its unique and renowned faculty, clinicians, and administration. Scholl continues its commitment to excellence in the field of podiatric medicine.
Come follow us as we now take a tour of the school.
Can't buy me love.
Here we are at the entrance of the Health Science Building, where the Dr. William M. Scholl College is now located. On an average day, nearly 1,000 university students enter the Health Science Building. The college has nearly 400 students enrolled from over 40 states and provinces. Some of these students come to attend class, others come to socialize, some even study.
Let's go see what the new classrooms look like. Basic science classes are usually held in rooms similar to this. The average capacity is around 90 seats.
Professors use the new computer system to display lectures via PowerPoint.
Paper disc with oxygen embedded or impregnated in it that inhibits the growth of the organism.
Also an added benefit, students have access to these same computer systems to arrange meetings, study sessions, and display projects. How do you work this thing?
Here, let a pro show you. This is Rhodes Auditorium, where the larger lecture classes are held. This is the Gross Anatomy course. Currently, podiatry students take this course with medical students at the Rosalind Franklin University.
And what would a gross anatomy course be without an anatomy lab? Here are some students independently studying cadavers. Students are required to dissect their own cadavers, but many times students collectively review the material together. Here in the Sheena Anatomy Lab, Rosalind Franklin University has instituted a state-of-the-art web video dissector. Gross anatomy dissections can now be viewed on a computer monitor by students before they take the plunge into their own dissections.
Lab dissection videos can be accessed by every student at the university. Dr. Breither, professor and assistant dean of basic biomedical sciences, dissected the lower extremity used for this specialized section of the video dissector.
The lumen dissector was developed by Dr. Mark Abel, associate professor of cell biology and anatomy. All video dissections are demonstrated by course coordinator Dr. Maynard, associate professor and department chair.
Not only will these dissections be available to gross anatomy students, but other courses such as surgery and biomechanics will also have access to these videos to further offer ways of instruction to students.
This is the popliteal fossa. This is a right lower extremity.
The video dissector can be accessed anywhere on campus with any computer, so students can study anatomy without having to actually be in the lab.
Due to the many advances in technology, our university has now integrated histology slides into a large database. Now, instead of having microscopes and slides, histology class takes place in computer labs, giving students a more independent study of the course.
What's a microscope?
Shh, we're in the library right now. There are two computer labs in the library where any university student can access the internet or use it as a workstation. The Boxer University Library is the main library for students on campus. There are lots of places to study and hide away from distractions. Students take full advantage of the high-speed connections available, as well as the many late-night vending machines.
There are many opportunities available to students interested in research. From diabetes to microbiology, professors are always looking for new students to help in their labs.
Recently, the College of Podiatric Medicine hired a new dean of advanced research.
Scholl has a great reputation and a very long history of doing cutting edge work in research. We are the busiest research unit in the world in podiatry. And we are the largest diabetic foot research unit in the world as well. We work collaboratively with probably 8 or 10 different sites around the world, at least on a regular basis, on a variety of subjects. Our particular favorite area is in the diabetic foot. And our group, which is called the Center for Lower Extremity Ambulatory Research, or CLEAR, is really privileged to be at the cutting edge in that field, and by virtue of its diversity in others in the field of lower extremity work. We've just completed the largest ever study antibiotics for diabetic foot infections. Just published a major paper on prevention in the Journal of the American Medical Association. That's the first such manuscript on prevention in JAMA. We collaborate and had publications in over the last 6 months in the Lancet and also in New England Journal. So there's a lot of attention being focused on this field right now. So it's a very exciting time, and all eyes are on podiatry. What's been lacking in this profession has been there hasn't been a culture. Our profession is so young, and there hasn't been a culture of mentorship in podiatry. And ultimately, you're not judged, I think, when you leave when you leave an institution on how many papers you've written, or how many surgeries you've done, or how many lectures you've given in whatever countries. You're judged on your professional progeny, who you've produced in the past. And our profession, which has been primarily a private practice centric based profession, has never had any reason to work in that realm and to seize in that realm. We've had great mentors in the past, and we continue to, but we haven't had a culture and a tradition of that. And that, if you're asking me what my biggest research project is, that's it.
Here we are in the GATE Lab with Carl Mangold, a second-year podiatry student.
Well, the GATE Lab is something that's somewhat unique to Scholl. We have a lot of equipment that has accumulated over the years. Actually, individual students can apply to purchase equipment, which is something that I did for my project. We have a lot of resources at our disposal here in the GATE Lab, and it's a really great opportunity to do a really wide range of research.
Thank you, Carl. The GATE Lab has resources to facilitate many types of research, but all this research makes me feel like working out.
This 24-hour access workout facility is free to all students, faculty, and staff. Students like Jess here take advantage of the availability and convenience. There are many running, climbing, and elliptical machines, as well as free weights and barbells for heavy workouts. However, I'm about ready to eat. Let's head to the cafeteria.
The main cafeteria is located next to the Boxer Library on campus. There is a variety of food stations for various purposes. Seating is available for well over 500 occupants. Many students, faculty, and staff enjoy a quiet lunch hour or socialize until classes resume in the afternoon.
Here is the Rathskeller Student Union. It's more rowdy and cozy compared to the cafeteria, but it's usually the best place to meet your friends to have a quick bite. There are also microwaves and refrigerators available for those who bring their meals from home. Also, wireless access to the internet is available to anyone with a wireless connection. There are also consoles conveniently located in the union to allow quick checks of emails, news, or highlights.
The locally renowned Feet First Museum has also moved with the college. The museum displays the history of podiatric medicine as well as the history of the college itself.
Scholl students remain involved at school as well as in community. Recently, students traveled to Springfield, Illinois to lobby to state officials about the importance of our future profession in the state of Illinois.
Also, this past summer, five students from the class of 2007 flew 2,000 miles overseas to Ghana, Africa for a medical service mission. There, they spent 1 month learning of the culture and serving in the local hospitals as medical volunteers. Let's listen in on their experience.
Thank you. 1 year here is about 10 years. Let's be very honest. Yeah. Because the challenges are so enormous. Yeah. You will see so much in just a year. 10 years, you won't be able to see so much. You do everything.
You do everything by yourself.
Yeah, because there are cases you can't refer. But the nearest center with the requisite expertise is maybe 100 miles with very horrible road to go through. But here, there's no alternative. So you have to go it.
Of course, there are plenty of people who live on campus in the new housing units designed for singles as well as students with families. Let's check out the crib of a typical podiatric medical student.
Howdy, welcome to our crib. What you waiting for? Come on in. We'll start off right over here. This is the kitchen, my favorite room. You can see we got this nice cutout over here with the bar. All the appliances came ready to go in the apartment, brand new. So it's fully furnished pretty much in the kitchen area. The great things also are that we don't have to pay for the heating or the water. We only have to pay for the electricity, which comes out to just about $20 a month. Pretty economic. Good Texas theme going on. I don't care what you do for stacks. I know the world glued your back to the wall. You gotta fall through that.
The big screen over here, great for entertaining. As well, the rest of the living room you can see here. It's a little tight, but it's nice and cozy for the two of us. We have living room area, dining room area, the bar over here for hanging out. As well, you can see the school is just minutes away across the parking lot. Katie actually works at the school.
We don't exactly have a garage, but look at all of our wonderful parking space. We have a few cars, but we're hoping to add to our collection.
Come on back here and check out the bedroom. Let's get ghosts in the phantom. You can bring your friend,
we can make this a tandem. Or you can come by yourself.
This is the bedroom area. We got a desk in here for all the studying action. Takes place. Spent a lot of time at this desk. We got some pathology coming up. It's really going to be a tough final. As you can see, again, the furniture we had to bring in ourselves. Otherwise, everything else was taken care of for us. I got this nice piece right here at IKEA. They told me it's going to be really hot soon. So as you can see, the apartment really is a nice place. It's a pretty special option for living, considering it's so close to school. Come back here and check out the bathroom. What you want me to do? So we got closets, nice lush space, as well the bathroom area, decorated in style. Well, thanks for stopping by. It was nice of you to tour our crib. I got to get back to studying now, so.
And I've got to get back to work, so y'all get the heck out.
Okay, let's see. We've covered the classrooms, the laboratories, the library, the workout facilities, the cafeteria, the student union, and the on-campus student housing.
Now let's explore the clinical aspects of pediatric medicine offered to the students at Rosalind Franklin University. The EEC, Education and Evaluation Center, is a replica of Working Health Services Clinic. Having all the amenities of an actual clinic, students perform and practice physical exams and histories on actors and actresses hired to mimic certain health problems encountered with real life.
Here, two physician assistant students are evaluating each other before a cumulative final. They are practicing the skills that all medically trained professionals receive before they move on to external rotations.
Podiatric medical students from Scholl College are integrated in the university clinic system of assessment and treatment, and students see patients on a weekly basis.
This is what makes our education into knowledge. Putting into practice what we've learned during classes allows students to step into the real world of medicine, practice, and professionalism.
Hi, I'm Dr. Beth Jarrett. I am an
associate professor in the Department of Biomechanics and Orthopedic Disease at Scholl College. I've been teaching for almost 17 years now. I've been asked to talk about the clinical experience at Scholl College. The clinic up here, our second and third year students work together and they see whatever comes in the door, which I think is working out much better in that they get a much broader experience than they had been getting at the other clinic. Merging with the university has been a very good thing all around, both academically and clinically. The difference here is that the treatment room number one are all brand new, so the surroundings are much improved. From an educational experience, it broadens their experiences. They get a much better perspective on what podiatry is all about, and they have an improved confidence level because they do see more clinical types of patients.
And that's the day in the life of a student. Thank you for going on our tour with us, but now we have to get back to studying. Bye!
And as I say, home alone, y'all come back now, you get it. I can feel broken, man, but here I am.